Good morning, children.
Good morning.
Welcome back to the math class. In the previous classes, we have learned finished two chapters, that is factorization and compound interest. Today we start with a totally new chapter, but then the concept of this chapter somewhere or the other you have already done in your lower grade. That's why in the beginning of grade 9 we are taking those chapters which you are little familiar with, so that it is not completely new for you. Okay, so now for example, today we have taken expansion. We had shared the pictures of this chapter. You can see that expansion is all about formulas, expanding, right? Expansion is expanding. Expanding in what sense? We have heard of this word in maybe physics and all sciences. We use expansion even in chemistry. Then what are we doing with expansion or expanding in math? It is basically about formulas. How? For example, I have written down the formulas for you. For the first one, a plus b the whole square. Now if you see, number of terms inside the bracket are how many? They are just two terms, a plus b, with a bracket raised to 2. So when I open up the bracket, what is happening now? It is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square, right? So from two terms inside a bracket, now we have got into three terms when we expand that formulae. So it's all about the formulas which you have already, some of it you have already learnt in your lower grade. I'm very sure that the first and the second one is at the fingertips of your of yours, because first, second and the fifth, we have used it n number of times last year in grade 8. A plus b the whole square, a minus b the whole square, and our favorite, a square minus b square, is what? A plus b into a minus b. So this year we are going to learn a whole lot of other formulas in this chapter, which you will be using in your higher grades from now on. Okay, so first you will be writing down all these formulas. So what you can do is, if you haven't written, no problem, now you can pay attention to the board, and later on when the class gets over for the day, you can leave a page and you can first write down all the formulas and then start. So today's work, you leave a page and then start with the exercise. Okay, that way also we can do, not an issue. Now the first formula is a plus b the whole square. We are very clear, it's a square plus 2ab plus b square. Second one is also very clear, it's a minus b the whole square is a square minus 2ab plus b square. Now I would want you to look at the third one, left hand side. If you see left hand side, it's a plus b the whole square plus a minus b the whole square. Have you seen the left hand side somewhere already on this board? Yes, if you see, a plus b the whole square is the first one and a minus b the whole square is the second one. So that means what I'm doing the operation over here, I'm adding both of them, right? So when I add both of them, what is the formula that I get? I get 2 bracket a square plus b square. Now if you're worried, how did I get? It's very easy. As I told you, I have added the first two. So if you see, I have added the first two means, I'll show it on this side of the board for your understanding. So it's a plus b the whole square plus a minus b the whole square. So I have added the left hand side of the first two. Now I'll add the right hand side of the first two. So it was a square plus 2ab plus b square plus a square minus 2ab plus b square. What do you think? Is there any like term which can be cancelled? Yes, I can see a plus 2ab and a minus 2ab, right? So the terms are same, the signs are different, so I can cancel. So now how many a squares are there? 2. And how many b squares are there? 2. So can I write it as 2a square plus 2b square? But we have already learned factorization. In factorization, what do? We take common out. So if I take 2 common out, what remains is a square plus b square. Bingo, I got my formula, 2 bracket a square plus b square. So the third formula is derived from where? Adding the first two. So if by chance in exam you forget the formula, you can do this part in rough work and you get the formula. So that's why I've shared this with you, how to get that formula. Understood everybody? Great. Now look at the fourth one. What do you think the fourth one is? If third one was addition, what is the fourth one about? Fourth one is about subtraction, right? That means when I subtract, obviously when I subtract, that means here what will be the sign? Again, I'll consider first two. I'll subtract. So the first three terms will be the same positive, but the second three terms, what will happen when there's a minus sign outside? The sign changes, right? So when the sign changes, what will happen is I will have the same terms, but now I'll write minus a squared plus 2ab minus b squared. Now do we have like terms? Again, yes, a squared minus a squared gets cancelled. Terms are same, signs are different. Plus b squared minus b squared. Again, it gets cancelled. So what remains? 2ab plus 2ab, which adds up to 4ab. So I've got the fourth formula as well. Understood? Can you show a thumbs up sign to that you're clear about it? Great. So it's pretty easy. And here basically we have to just apply these formulas. So if we remember the formulas by heart, then the application becomes very easy. Okay. Now if you see the fifth one, our favorite, a plus b the whole square into a minus b the whole square is a square minus b square. Right? Now look at the sixth one. What do you think? The sixth one, a plus 1 upon a the whole square. A plus 1 upon a the whole square. What do you think? Does this look like some other sum which I've already done? What do you think it is? Which one? Can anybody answer? You raise your hands and I'll unmute you. Which other formula does this resemble? Which is already there on the board and which we have already discussed now. What do you think? Which one is it? Yes, I got a hand raised over here of Akshat. Yes, Akshat.
Ma'am, it is A plus B.
Very good. Very good, Akshat. And I've got some few answers from, I don't know, somebody with the name 90, Ritika, Ovia. All have given the correct answer. Yes, it resembles A plus B, the whole square. So what's the difference between the first and the sixth? Why I need to learn both? The difference is where A is same, but in place of B, in the sixth one, I have 1 plus A. 1 plus A means it's the reciprocal of the first term. That's the only difference. Otherwise, it's the same formula. So, if I have A plus B, the whole square, I write it as what? I write it as A square plus 2AB plus B square. And here I have now A plus 1 upon A, the whole square. So, it is A square plus 2. Now, in place of B, I have 1 upon A. So, I will write A into 1 upon A plus 1 upon A the whole square. So A square as it is. Can I cancel anything over here? Yes, numerator has A and denominator also has A. Right? So A gets cancelled. So 2 plus 1 upon A square. Is this answer same as the sixth one? Yes, the answer is same. Only 2 I have written in the center. Over there it's on the last term. That doesn't mind, the formula is exactly the same. So, sixth is nothing but the application of fifth, where your first, where your B is what? It is nothing but the reciprocal of the first term. Remember reciprocal. That means if I have 5A, then I can have, for example, 5A ka reciprocal is 1 upon 5A, right? Remember this very well. 5a reciprocal is 1 upon 5a. So I can apply this formula. Or if I have a plus 2 upon a, the whole square. Second example, can I apply the sixth formula over here? Can I apply the sixth formula over here? Sibangi? I have unmuted you. I can see your hand raised. 1 minute, huh, Mita? Yes, Sibangi. I'm not able to unmute Sibangi. Okay. Just 1 minute, huh? Yes, Sibangi, you're unmuted. Can you please tell me whether you're having a doubt or you want to answer this question? Hello? Hello? I can't hear Sibangi. Okay. Now my question over here, I will be asking to Indraneel because he has raised his hands over here. Yes, Indraneel, can I apply the sixth formula a plus 1 upon a the whole square for this sum?
Yes, ma'am.
You can?
Yeah.
Okay. I think you have got the wrong answer, Vita. I said a and it's reciprocal. Now here I have written a and here I have written 2 upon a. Is 2 upon a the reciprocal of a?
No, ma'am.
Understood. So I can apply the sixth formula, but I can definitely apply the first formula where my A and B becomes my 2 upon E. Okay. Why I ask this question specifically is because this is a common mistake which children makes many a time, that they assume this A is here. So that means obviously it's a reciprocal. But there's a 2 upon A. 2 upon A, children, is not the reciprocal of A. 2 upon A is the reciprocal of A upon 2. So I cannot apply this formula. If this was my question, A upon 2, its reciprocal is 2 upon A. Yes, now I can apply my sixth formula over here. Understood the difference? How to apply which formula? This is very important. Okay? So that's why I have used this for your understanding. Anukrishna, do you have a doubt, Beta? I can see a hand risen over here.
No, ma'am, that is for the worksheet only.
Okay, Beta, then lower your hand. Sometimes I get a little confused. Yeah. No? That's why. Okay, thank you, Beta. Okay, so till here, is it clear? I can see Indraneel has raised his hands. Or clear?
Ma'am, actually, I don't understand the sixth one.
The sixth formula. Okay, the sixth formula is, I have shown over here, it's nothing but a special case of A plus B the whole square. So, in place of A, I have A. In place of B, I have 1 upon A. So when I apply a square plus 2ab plus b square, so here the same way, a square 2ab. Now b is what? It is 1 upon a. So I have in place of b, I have written 1 upon a plus 1 upon a the whole square in place of b square. Now here I can cancel a and a because they are in the numerator and denominator. So I got my answer a square plus 2 plus 1 upon a square. Is it clear now, Vita?
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Great. Good. Okay. So, this was the sixth formula. Similarly, we have the seventh formula, which is A minus 1 upon A the whole square. A square plus 1 upon a square minus 2. Remember, in a minus b the whole square, the middle term is minus, right? Same way here also, the middle term I have written it as minus 2. The middle term I have written in the end. If you want, you can write in between. This and this, they both mean the same. Placement of the term doesn't change the expression. This and this both mean the same. So this is nothing but the special case of question formula, second one. Okay. Now look at the eighth one. Eighth one is similar to like our fifth one, which is a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. Understood, everybody? Now let's look at the ninth formula. Ninth formula is what? I've added the sixth and the seventh. Ninth formula is when I've added the sixth and the seventh. Just like I have done in my third formula. So I got my answer as 2 bracket a square plus 1 upon a square. Right? So I have not written the next one. I will write only the left hand side. And I want you to tell me what will be the right hand side. Okay? In the ninth one, we had done addition. Now I am doing subtraction. Right? Now this formula is similar to which one? From here, from the first five. Let me know. And who wants to answer? Raise your hand. I will ask that person. Who wants to answer? Only Anukrishna? Okay. I'll ask. Ritika, can you answer, Vita?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what do you think will be the answer?
Ma'am, it is similar to the fourth formula.
Right, very good.
And I think so the answer will be...
it's okay, ma'am,
same
time.
Like it's 4a plus...
Fourth one, the answer is 4ab. So here, yes. What do you think will be the answer?
4a into 1 upon a.
Perfect. 4a into 1 upon a. Where can I cancel a and a?
Yes, ma'am.
So what do you think will be the answer? Final answer is only 4. It's only 4. Understood, okay. Everybody? Right?
Yes, ma'am.
It was pretty easy. Very good, Ritika. You should always try whether... it is right or wrong, but we should always try. Okay? So, the 10th one, when we have subtraction, the answer is only 4. Got it, everybody? Good. Yes, Kushal, Siddharth, Akshat, Ruja have all given the correct answer. It resembled the 4th one. Good job. Now, let's go on and do the next formula. The next one is the 11th one. Which is a plus b plus c the whole square. Till now, we were only expanding the formula where we had two terms inside the bracket. Now we have three terms inside the bracket. So how do we do that? We have a formula for that, okay? It's pretty easy. Let me tell you that part. That much I can guarantee. So I'll write it down. It's a square plus b square plus c square plus... I can write it as 2ab plus bc plus ca. This is the formula. I'll read it again. A plus b plus c the whole square is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2 bracket ab plus bc plus ca. So this is when we expand three terms with a square outside the bracket. How many terms do we get? We get 6 terms inside the outside the bracket. Okay? So this is the formula. Now there are different cases for this formula. Different cases. Right? What are the different cases? I can have a minus over here and a plus over here. I can have a plus and a minus over here. I can have both minus over here. I can have different cases. So do you will, your question will, ma'am, so many formulas you will have to remember? No, we can do all those special cases using this one formula. Right? or if you want, you can use the formulas also, not an issue. I'll tell you how to solve that special cases using this formula. Let me first give an example using this one. Simple, if I say 2x plus y plus z is my question over here. Right? So it will be what? First is a square. So now my a is 2x, b is y, and c is z. Right? So I have a square. So that means 2x the whole square plus y the whole square plus z the whole square. First three terms are square of each terms. So I have written that plus 2ab. AB means I have to multiply the first and the second term. So it is 2x into y. Dot means into, right? Then b, c. B and c. So it is y into z plus c into a. So z into 2x. So it will be what? It will be nothing but 4x square plus y square plus z square plus what? 2 outside. This will be written as 2xy plus yz plus 2xz. If you want, you can leave it like this or you can open the bracket. So when you open the bracket, what will happen? The final answer will be 4x square plus y square plus z square. 2 will be multiplied with only the first or all three? It will be multiplied with all three. So I will have 4xy plus 2yz plus 4xz. Xz or zx both mean the same. Is it clear, everybody? Yes? I have Ria over here who has raised her hands. Yes, Ria? You have a doubt, Bita?
Ma'am, I did not understand what you did.
Okay. I have just substituted. I have taken an example. This is how our exercise sums are going to be. This is our formula. And our exercise sums will be like this. Where they will ask, expand 2x plus y plus z the whole square. So first thing is I have to think of which formula does it same resemble. So here it resembles three terms with a plus sign inside the bracket and square. So it is nothing but a plus b plus c the whole square. Is this part clear till now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now if I compare, my a is what? 2x. B is what? Y. And c is what? Z. So what did I do? I have just written all these terms in this form, in the formulae form. So in place of a square, I have written 2x the whole square. In place of b square, I have written y square plus z square. Like that, I have just done the substitution. You remember I always say formula and then the substitution? So that is what I have done.
Yes.
And then I have now opened up the bracket because this was 2x the whole square. So when I open the bracket, it will become 4x square, right? Because 2 into 2 is 4, x into x is x square. Then same here, y square, z square, and here I have multiplied 2xy, yz and 2zx. Again, there was a bracket. Expansion means I open up all the brackets. So here I have opened up the bracket in the last step. So the first three were same, and this I too have multiplied with all the three terms. So it becomes 4xy plus 2yz plus 4xz. Understood?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Welcome, Bita. Okay. So this part is clear. Rucha, do you have a doubt? Rucha, today I'm not able to unmute you. If you want, you can write the question in the chat. Important is I want to clear your doubt. So if I'm not able to unmute you, you can write your doubt in the chat section. And here, Shreya, I could unmute you. Shreya?
Yeah. Ma'am, do we have to write the... Yeah, ma'am. Do we have to write the formula?
Every time. Remember, 1 mark is for formula and its actual substitution. So in each and every sum, you will be writing it down. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome, beta. So this is also done. Now, can I go to the next example, which I was talking about? Right? Akshat. Akshat has a doubt, but I can't. Akshat, I can see here. Yes, Akshat, what's the doubt?
I have a doubt, like, if in the last formula which you did, A plus B plus C, the whole square.
Right.
In that, if it is A minus B plus C, the whole square, then what it will be?
Yes, I was coming to that part only now. I'm going to explain that part, the special case which can come up, okay? So, I've asked the right question at the right time. Now, I'll give the explanation for that, okay? So, here it goes, okay? Listen. Children, there's only 5 minutes remaining for our this meeting to get over. We'll join back again. Don't worry, okay? So, now, Akshat has asked, ma'am, what if the question is A minus B plus C the whole square? Simple. Can I write this as A plus minus B plus C the whole square? Minus B, I have written as plus of minus B. So when I multiply plus into minus is minus. So if you see, I have made this special case exactly like my 11th formula. Only thing is now in place of B, wherever B is there, what I'll be substituting? I'll be substituting minus B. So what do you think the formula will become? The formula will become A square plus minus B the whole square plus C square plus 2 A into minus B plus minus B into C plus C into A. So this is nothing but A square minus B the whole square. Minus B into minus B is what? It's plus B square. So I will have plus B square plus C square plus 2 minus AB minus BC plus CA. So this is your formula, what it becomes. Or if I open up the bracket, it will be A square plus B square plus C square minus 2AB minus 2BC plus 2AC. So this is the formula. So either you remember this formula or you remember only this formula and try to understand. Whichever method you feel easy, you can use both the method. This special case, I made it look similar to my 11th formula and then I have solved this and got my formula. I hope it is clear now, Akshat. And everybody else as well. Now, those who don't want all this, ma'am, what to do, why all this, if you want, for your benefit, I can write down all the other special cases as well. And I'll leave the decision to you. Either you use this method or you directly write the formulas. It's up to you. I'll leave it for you. Okay? So I will write down all the formulas for your whichever choice you want to make. Okay? Is it fine, everybody? Can I do that? Yes, I'll write down the formula. Okay? And I'll also tell you how to remember the formula. It's very easy. Even if you want to remember the special cases also, it's very easy. I'll let you know how it is, okay? So 12th one, I'll write it down. A plus B minus C the whole square. A square plus B square plus C square plus 2AB minus 2BC minus 2AC. Then 13th one is A minus B plus C the whole square. A square plus B square plus C square minus 2AB minus 2BC plus 2AC. And the 14th one, A minus B minus C the whole square. A square plus B square plus C square minus 2AB plus 2BC minus 2AC. All these three formulas are not there in your textbook. Formula 12, 13, 14 is not there in your textbook. I have written it for you. If you want, you can write these formulas and you can directly apply this formula. I'll tell you how to remember this formula. Okay? How to remember? It's very easy. If you see in all four, the square terms obviously is going to be plus every time because square of a negative is also positive. So these first three terms will be plus, same in all. Now here, I have C as negative, right? So A and B are positive. So since A and B are positive, I have plus 2AB. Now I'm multiplying B and C. But here C is negative. That's why I have minus 2BC. And now in the third, I'm multiplying first and third. So C is negative. So that's why I get minus 2AC. Understood? Same way, look at the 13th one. First three same. Now, 2AB, but B is what? Negative. So that's why minus 2AB.